Today's lesson, we're going to start opening the interval. After the fourth and the fifth, we're going to have the sixth, that's pretty much an extended fifth. So the important thing in a sixth stays really in the first joint of the thumb. And then with the index finger, we're going to push the mallet and we're going to go to the octave. That is our main motion that we have. So, index finger push and we go to the octave. Notice here, when we go to the octave, yeah, so everything is nice and relaxed and round here. Yeah, in some cases you can also go to the octave and slightly let it open. If you do this fast, probably that's the way you would like to do. So here in the left hand, take a look. The interval is a little bit bigger. Thumb and index finger, throw the mallet to the octave. Okay, it's important when you come to the octave, you feel everything is under control here. So the pivot. So now let's view carefully this new motion from the sixth to the octave. So sixth and octave. Sixth, the index finger will push to here to the octave. Now let's take a look here. That's the most important part. The external mallet is always in the same place and always should be held with the ring finger and this ring finger bent. So here you have the six, you have a lot of space. And when you have the octave, you still have the same space here. Okay, let's talk about this middle finger that's very important. The middle finger should stay out and slightly touch the mallet. Be careful because if you close the middle finger like this and if you touch the mallet, that's the original Burton grip. But then you're going to be lacking of independence and you're going to have the hand in a parallel position. So be sure when you go to six to octave, you always keep the middle finger out of the way and always a lot of space in both. Okay, now just practice this exercise in our table. See how it goes here. So sixth and eighth, octave, sixth and eighth. You can try also as a single. Okay, let's see this on a keyboard now. So now practicing the sixth and the octave in a keyboard, we have exercise number four, is just in sixth. I keep a fifth here in the left hand and just gonna start running in sixth. That you got the feel what the sixth is about. Okay, and be creative. You can be probably do it with singles. Because independent if it's singles or parallel, the interval is always the same. Then practice the sixth also in the left hand here, so we have. And so on.